So I bet that you just updated Plex and you lost audio on a bunch of your files. We'll fix that. I got you. So the problem is this codec here, EAC3. I bet you anything, if you open up the file that you're having problems with the audio with, it's going to be an EAC3 codec. So the problem that's happening is you're probably on Windows 11, but there's something about the way that Windows 11 deals with this codec and Plex deals with this codec that's incompatible. I can't explain it for you. I know that a file is outdated, so we're going to replace that file. That's been working for me for a long time, but just today it stopped working. But luckily, there is a fix for that too. I'm going to give a shout out to the two people who helped me fix these at the end of this video. The first way we're going to do this is by replacing a file that may exist. So what I need you to do is navigate to this location in Program Files, Plex, Plex. In here, you might have a file that is called mpv-2.dll. If you have that, we're going to fix that right now. If not, you can skip to the next timecode. Should be a timecode in the description. So the first thing you want to do is go to this SourceForge page. However, currently SourceForge is down for me. Don't know what's up with that. Should be up shortly, but the link is here and I'll put the link in the description. I'll make sure you get there. Don't worry. So when you download that file, put it somewhere safe. You'll have this folder, which is the file that you just downloaded. This is what it should look like. You don't really have to worry about these. I just keep them around for posterity. Take your mpv2dll and copy it. Then what you want to do is create a shortcut that goes to this folder, this Plex Plex folder here that holds your mpv2dll. And you can just paste it in here, replace the file and destination, and it might ask you for another confirmation. Go ahead and do that. And if you had the mpv2dll, that will have fixed it. Just restart Plex and it'll start working again. At least in my experience. However, today that didn't work because that file no longer existed. So maybe it doesn't exist for you anymore. There's a new way to fix that now too. So come to this website. There'll be a link in the description. This is the Dolby AC3 and AC4 installer. Click on download now. It'll download. And then when you unzip the file, you'll have two installers in here. This is what they look like. This one here you can see is AC4. So this one is AC3. I didn't install the AC4, but I'm going to. In fact, I'll just do that right now so you can see what the process looks like. Why not? Install. Done. We're good. So after I did that, I didn't even need to restart Plex. It just started working again. So maybe just install this and you'll never have to deal with that file again. This will just work. Lastly, I want to give a shout out to the people that helped fix this. The first one was actually in this forum here. This is Shulia or Shuia. I'm not sure if that's an I or an L. They were the only person anywhere that had any fix for this. So thank you. And lastly, literally 5 hours ago, someone commented that they've been doing it this way for a while and they found a solution for the recent error or the recent break, and this worked. So yes, thank you, Whole Paramedic 8783. You the bomb.